most love about prayer is that God answers you when he speaks to you, when you speak to him.
So the thing I most love about prayer is probably that no matter what the answer is, you definitely know that God is there and he's listening to you, whatever you're saying.
The thing I most love about prayer is seeing the change that it makes in people's lives.
I mostly hear the voice of God through scripture. I'm a man of the word. The word means a lot to me, and God speaks to me regularly. On a daily basis, he speaks to me through his word.
The first release in prayer is to know that you pray best when you are being yourself. That matters not one iota whether you are anything like Smith Wigglesworth or John Wesley or William Booth. What matters is that you are you, and he is in you, and he is waiting in you. And the more time you spend being you, the more time you are going to spend in his astonishing, exciting presence.
Jesus had to work to maintain his focus in the midst of training his followers, meeting needs, public speaking, demanding crowds, and a very busy schedule. He made sure he regularly made time to get away with his Father to talk things over.
I just thought, as I read that phrase, wouldn't it be a wonderful thing if we could say, through the silence of the night, we were listening to the voice of God.
Watching out, sharpening our antennas, being aware that the enemy seeks to oppose us as we go deeper into a prayerful relationship with God.
There is a danger with God that we come into his presence and we rush straight to his hand because we want to get something off him. We want to take something out of his hand. When what God most of all wants to do is for us to look into his face.
Well, I come from the Anglican tradition where obviously liturgy is very central to the way I was brought up. Although even when I was a child being prepared for confirmation, the priest told me about arrow prayers.
The person of Jesus just came and sat next to me in my sorrow and met with me in that place of desperation. I've been in such a desperate place.
If I have sort of 2 days on the trot without having had time with God alone, I begin to miss him. And it's one of the most wonderful gifts to be able to miss God and actually think, you know, what I really feel like I need is getting back to spending some time with my Father.
I've noticed that my prayer as I've got older has become much more silent. Much less about the things that I have to say and much more about my heart and God's heart just coming together, really.
One thing I ask from the Lord, this only do I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze on the beauty of the Lord and to seek him in his temple.